Let me recall a few sentences with which we began these classes. Vowels are independent, can be pronounced independently. Consonants are dependent on the vowels for pronunciation. That is, consonants cannot be pronounced by themselves. So, we have to add a vowel to make it pronounceable. This I made clear in the beginning. Now, we know these are the consonants, and naturally, these should have been added with some vowel or other. Otherwise, I would not have been able to pronounce any of these letters. How to distinguish a consonant? The easiest method possible has been found out for that. That is to say, put a dot above and it becomes a consonant. I have been pronouncing it as ka, nga, cha, nya, ta, na, etc. Now that I have put the dot above, they are consonants and they cannot be pronounced without the help of a vowel. So, if I have to pronounce this separately, I have to say ik or im. I take the help of a vowel to begin with so that I can end the sound with this. So, the definition that a consonant cannot be pronounced independently is proved. For this, a vowel is added and it becomes ka. This is consonant ik. A vowel is added, that is a is added, ik plus a becomes ka. I called it ka in the beginning. Hope you remember. This is actually the consonant ik plus a. So, this becomes ka. So, also na, cha, nya, all the letters. So, these consonantal vowels alone make the language. They form into words and words form the language. Once you are thorough with these consonants, I hope you are, because you have to put only a dot above the letters which I have taught and then call it a consonant. Let me start with ka. You know that. What is this? Na. Now, I will read it as ka. Na, ka, na. I put a dot above. What is this now? Kan, kan means an eye. Kan, an eye. One more word. What is this? Pa. This is la. Pa, la. Pa, la, pa, la. Of course, this is a word and it has a meaning. I am not going to trouble you with that meaning now. I am concentrating upon the consonants. A consonant is a letter with a dot above. So, I put a dot above this. And what is now? Fa and la with a dot l. Fa l. Pal. Pal is a tooth. One more word so that we can frame a couple of words meaning something different. A. I put a consonant here. When I mean a consonant, naturally it must have a dot above. What is this? A. N. A. N. 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 It has a meaning. A word must have a meaning. A word is a combination of letters and sounds, but it must have a meaning to be called a word. So, N is my. You have come to know three different words with the available letters you have learned. I put this here. What is this? N. What does it mean? My. I take this up and put it before kan. N, kan. Two words. N, kan. N meaning my. Kan meaning an I. N, kan, my, I. Now, you have started learning Tamil in all earnest. So also I join these two and that becomes un pal. Can you give me the meaning? Un means you are singular. Pal, a tooth. Un pal, your tooth. Now, this can be stretched. Every consonant needs a vowel to become a consonantal vowel. Now we have seen only a being added to these consonants. So this is a and I make it o. So it plus a naturally will become ka. How to indicate it? So this a, the sound A, the vowel A in combination with the consonant must have a symbol so that that consonant or vowel can be pronounced properly and rightly. So, what is the symbol? This is the symbol for A. How is this written? A vertical line going from the bottom, stretching itself and coming down. This is the form. If you take the circular method, it will be easy to write. This is a symbol, remember, this is a symbol to denote A. That is, this is the symbol to denote the elongated A. Elongated A. So naturally, I put this symbol here and it becomes ka. Ik plus A, ka. And the symbol remains the same all through.